Hey there, Matt Cutler from Blocknative. We'd like to tell you about one of our newest capabilities called Gas Platform. Gas Platform is Blocknative's take on a block prediction and gas estimation. We're using our global mempool data platform to inspect the contents of the mempool, to predict which transactions are likely to be in the next block, and then to make confidence estimations as to which gas prices are likely to be included at what confidence levels in the next block. It's a totally new take on how to do this, and we believe will provide much more accurate and real-time estimates of how to properly set gas so you get predictable performance without overpaying. Now, to get to Gas Platform, you can see it yourself here in Mempool Explorer. You can see this little gas widget up here on the right. This is Gas Platform. Now, critically, in order to see this, you must be logged in. If you go to Mempool Explorer and what you see looks like this, there's nothing here, it's because you're not logged in. Just go ahead and click the sign up button. It takes just a few minutes to create a Blocknative user account. And once you do, you will see this over here. Now, the free version of Mempool Explorer, the one that you get by default, will update the gas platform every 5 seconds, but our commercial accounts, it will update every second or even faster. Now, Gas Platform is available via an API. You can read about that in our documentation, but you can see it visually here, and it's relatively rich. And what I wanna do is walk through and show it to you and explain what the payloads mean, because it will help you properly interpret the data that you're getting off of Gas Platform. Now, to see these payloads, all you got to do is go over here to our gas widget, click the gear, and then there's two little checkboxes, show detail, click that one, and then show payload. Now, every time the little progress bar reaches the end, which in this case is 5 seconds, we'll get a new Gas Platform payload. These will just keep running in as long as this browser window is in the foreground. Now I'm gonna scroll up here and we're gonna start looking at these payloads and talk about what they mean because it's relatively rich. I'm actually gonna just click the auto scroll off so it doesn't jump. So this is powered by our API. So by default, we tell you the system is Ethereum, the network is main, the unit of measurement is Gwei. Okay. Now, what we're showing here, the current block number, this is the most recent confirmed block, is number 4214 here, right? But what we're really interested in, and you as a user are interested in, is in the next block, 4215, okay? And so what we're seeing here is this block number, 4214, was mined 16,127 milliseconds ago. So over 16 seconds ago, which not surprisingly, we see that the next payload we have, that's the block that's mined, right? But here we can see that was a while ago. So the next block is 4215. Our infrastructure, our nodes are looking at the mempool and saying, based on the current contents of the mempool and how the top of the mempool, the gas limits that are associated with those transactions, our best guess is that, or our projection is that there's 132 transactions that are going to be in this this block, and they have the following distribution. Now, we have developed a proprietary 14-feature model that basically calculates confidence intervals for inclusion in the next block. So what we're doing here is we're saying to be 99% sure that your transaction is going to get into this next block, 4215, the minimum gas price you can set is 252. And so the whole idea here is, if I really want to make sure I'm going to get in, 99% confidence interval is about as high as we can make it. This is the least you can pay. But you know what, if you want to back off a little bit of that, you want to save some on your gas, if you want to be in the 95th confidence interval, it's 231, the 90th interval, 224, and so on down here. Now, what's interesting and challenging about this problem is the mempool is a real-time streaming data environment. So every second, hundreds or thousands or even more transactions are flooding into the mempool and changing all of these numbers, changing the confidence intervals and the gas prices associated with them. And so our platform is ingesting all of that data in real time and recalculating these thresholds on the fly and then making them available to you as an end user here via Gas Platform and via Gas Widget. So as we scroll down here, here is the next block, 4216. You can see here to be in the 99th percent confidence interval, you needed a gas price of 259, but that was just about 1 second after it was mined. Now, as we go down here, Now we're on 4217. You can start to interpret these. It's interesting. So here's one, 4217, right? There's two events here with 4217. The 99th percent is 238. The 95th percent is 216. And as we go down, oh, look, as time rolls forward, to be in the 99% confidence interval, the price goes up because new transactions are flowing in. So it's actually pretty interesting to watch this data and as it changes over time. And you can consume this data in such a way that you can really target your transaction based on what's going on right now versus the next block. Now, this is great for end users who are trying to more accurately set gas and make sure you get predictable performance. It's great for automated systems like trading systems that need to make sure that their transactions go in right away and don't want to overspend and reduce their profitability. And it's great for protocols and dApps that want to provide input to users about how to properly set gas so that they're not overpaying or underpaying, particularly right now, given that gas prices are quite high. Now, if you want to get into the documentation of Gas Platform, if you go back to the default, you can either just open up Gas Platform, a new Explorer window, or hit reset. Sorry, I'm going to do that. This is continuing to go here, so I'm just going to reset that. And right here, you can see our documentation. If we click on that, down here is Gas Platform, and you can learn all about Gas Platform, how it works, and the various feeds that are there. If you have questions on this or want to have suggestions, we recommend that you join our Discord community. You can do so right here. Just click Join Discord, and you'll pop right over. It's a pretty vibrant community, and our whole technical team is there as well. We have a bunch of upgrades and changes planned across the portfolio at all times, but also for Gas Platform. So we're excited to have you go hands-on and to let us know what you think. And that is Blocknative Gas Platform. Thanks so much.